Are you creating income from your business, or are you creating wealth from your business? Two very different types of entrepreneurial businesses, and this difference is really important. I think that in sharing this with you, you have an opportunity to gain a brand new perspective, not just on what your business is right now, but what your business could be with the right type of focus and attention paid to it. So I want to talk about these two types of entrepreneurial businesses, the income business and the wealth business. So first off, what is an income business? Well, basically, it requires you. It requires you to be in it every day. And you can create actually a lot of income. And frankly, it can even make you rich. Like, you can retire rich in an income business. But success will ultimately be tied to you showing up, doing the work, putting the work in day after day, month after month, week after week, year after year. I did it out of order, right? But success is ultimately tied to you showing up. And when you decide it's time to retire, it's not like you can pass that business off to somebody else. It's not like you can just hand it off. It's not like you can pull out and have it continue to generate wealth for you or income for you. It's like when you stop showing up, the business closes. And honestly, right now, that's my business. Like, I'm, you know, that is my business. But there's an alternative. The alternative type of business is a wealth business. So for a wealth business, you might be working in and on it every day. You might still be there every day. You not being in the business is not a condition of it being a wealth business. The big difference is that this business grows bigger than you. The business becomes bigger than you. It becomes not tied directly to you showing up and doing the work. And the way that it does that is through systems. Systems to create results for clients, systems to create results for your business. It's not based on personal talent anymore, even though personal talent is consistently going in there. It can be your talent, it can be other people's talent, consistently going in there and creating those systems. It is the systems themselves that start to become wealth generators. And when you do this, when you build a business around systems, it can scale, and it can even be sold for the value of the systems, not necessarily for the value of the people, of the talent. And what that means is the value potential of that business grows far beyond you, the owner of the business, the creator, the founder of the business. And the more your business is based in systems, the less the value of the business is based in you showing up. And ultimately, a goal can be to create systems for which you are no longer required. And sure, you can stay involved from a strategic perspective, but on a day-to-day basis, if you want to build a wealth business, it's going to be something that you can step away from, and other people can continue to deliver the value that the business is creating in the world, and you don't have to be involved. And when that's the case, you know, you can either keep that as a cash cow and have it keep pouring money into your accounts for life, or you can sell it. Like, you can just take a one-time big payday by growing the business as far as it makes sense for you to grow it with these systems in place and putting these systems in place, and then just cash out. And either way is a great option for a wealth business. And you ultimately, in your business, you can choose either. You can choose an income business, you can choose a wealth business. The key is to not get them confused, because if you think you're building a wealth business, but it's really an income business, you know, the day you retire, if you expect a business to keep cranking out the money, you know, you're going to be out of luck. And so if you recognize that you're building an income business and that's sufficient for you, like, and you're just going to create as much income as you need until you're as rich as you want to be, and then you cash out, or you know, you close shop, you walk away, and you just live off the spoils of your success. Like, that's great, that's fine. Or if you're just looking for, hey, I want a job to generate income. Like, I want, you know, there's a lot of people who get into, for example, freelance copywriting, which I consider to be an income business. Like, no matter if you have great contracts that are set up and you do a project and you get royalties, whatever, like, that's all still income. That's not wealth generation, right? There's no persisting value beyond your value creation from day to day in that business. And so don't get them confused. Decide, you know, is this an income business? Is this a wealth business? And what do I want it to be? So freelance copywriting, it's an income business. Other skilled services are income businesses. Like, as long as you're ultimately selling your time, your service, your work product, that's an income business, no matter how much income you generate. Now, there is a slight distinction here. Service by system. So if you create the system to deliver the service, and it's not just you that is delivering the service, but other people are following your system, that can be an income business if, like, it requires you to be there every day, but that can also be turned into a wealth business. Building an agency, same thing. It can be an income business if it requires you to be in there as the creative director or whatever, or it can be transformed into a wealth business if you make as much as possible in that business repeatable. Being a publisher, like my BTMS Insiders Training Library, that can be an income business, it can be a wealth business, right? Because it becomes much more scalable. Especially like if you start publishing other people's work and not just your own, that definitely becomes a wealth business. A shop, like an e-commerce shop or a physical shop or like a manufacturing business, or, you know, there can be all sorts of different businesses, right? Many types of businesses are either income or wealth businesses, depending on your decision to make them into a systematic delivery of value, or to have it be something where you have to be that center hub, that person in the middle of the wheel, and everything revolves around you. Because as long as you're that hub, if the wheel cannot spin without you, then you have an income business. And again, the key is all in the systems that you build. So can you make your skills and talents repeatable? Can you make what you do repeatable? Can you get all the processes that you follow to create success out of your head and have them be something that other people can follow? Can you break down the steps that it takes to create success and give them to somebody else, such that if they have sufficient talent to complete that type of work, they're able to succeed with that too? And if you do that, if you build those systems, you have the potential to build a wealth business. And if you can build it so it is beyond you, so you could go take a month-long vacation and come back and the business is running better than ever, then you know you've built a wealth business. But if you take a month-long vacation and everything falls apart or grinds to a stop or whatever, right, that's still an income business. Now, even an income business, like if you just want to be a freelance copywriter, even an income business can be maximized through systems. So what can you make repeatable? What can you delegate? What can you take off your plate so you're only doing your highest value activities? So an example of that, quite a few years back at this point, I decided that I was going to stop doing my own taxes, personal taxes, business taxes, all of that. For many years, I actually went from like January 1st to April 15th in this state of extreme stress because I was responsible for our taxes. And I'm not, like, by default, a good bookkeeper, numbers, accountant person, right? Like, it's painful for me to try and manage all of that and follow, like, fill out all the forms to just the right whatever. And then we got a bookkeeper, well, we got an accountant who could handle the taxes. And it started with the taxes, and they just did the taxes. And like that was, oh my goodness, it was such a weight off my shoulders. And what happened is between January 1st and April 15th, I had a brand new energy that I could bring to all of my highest value activities because my system for taxes was whatever that person asked me for, I give it to them. And then actually since then, in the last few years, I said what was happening was there was a lot of bookkeeping that wasn't really getting done very quickly because I was still responsible for the bookkeeping for my business. And so I turned around and I said, hey, can like I want to track my big numbers, right? But as far as categorizing transactions and making sure that that's ready for your entry into the tax stuff, like, can I just pay you a little bit of money and you handle that, right? And so in my income business, I was able to create a system that's basically give the right people the information they need to complete the result that they know how to complete better than me. And like, it instantly transformed my income business into being able to generate more income because I was no longer pulled into this task that was definitely a much lower value activity in terms of my work invested in exchange for the value that was received. And they're happy to do it because it takes them like 15 minutes and they're just like, boom, 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 it's done, right? So what can you take off your plate so you're only doing your highest value activities? And the more that you can make everything a system to maximize the more it will maximize your success, your income. And there is even a potential, like even if you're working in an income business right now, like freelance copywriting, to convert that business from an income business to a wealth business as it grows. So two types of business, income business versus wealth business. If you want to learn more about the types of systems that can either maximize your income business or grow a wealth business, I strongly recommend you attend a webinar that I'm doing on Thursday, tomorrow, with the author of Systemology, David Jennings. It's the best book on entrepreneurial business systems that I've ever read. It's really focused on how to turn a business that's just kind of everybody does what they're good at into a systemized, scalable, saleable business. And specifically, I've asked David to do a webinar for all Breakthrough Marketing Secret subscribers. So it's free if you're a subscriber. To talk about systemology for solopreneurs and virtual businesses, you know, like a lot of my audience runs, right? I've asked David to come on and talk about it, answer my questions, answer my subscriber questions. Again, as I'm publishing this video, that's tomorrow, Thursday, March 18th, 4 p.m. U.S. Central Time. And it's free for all Breakthrough Marketing Secret subscribers. You just have to sign up. Check out the link in the description to the webinar registration. And I strongly recommend you read David's book as well or get the audiobook, which is what I went through. I've included a link to get that on Amazon. What do you think? Let me know in the comments below on a scale 1 to 10 how valuable you found this lesson on income businesses versus wealth businesses and why. Like, what are your big takeaways or action items? Also, tap that like button before you go so you get more content like this delivered to you, and so the magical algorithms of the internet will share it with more people like you who will find it valuable. You can certainly share it with folks directly and subscribe before you go. Subscribe here. Also, go to breakthroughmarketingsecrets.com. Get my daily emails Monday through Friday, including these videos and more exclusive content for email subscribers like this Systemology webinar. It's going to be awesome. I hope to see you on there. My name is Roy Furr. This has been a video issue of Breakthrough Marketing Secrets. I always aim for 10 out of 10 value. I hope that I've delivered it here, and I look forward to seeing you again in your next video issue. See you soon. Bye.